Nipsey Hussle, last internal affairs obstruction, last opens an internal affairs inquiry in the Nipsey Hussle murder case. Los Angeles police have opened an internal affairs investigation into why the woman who drove the getaway car in the aftermath of rapper Nipsey Hussle's killing was sent home when she tried to turn herself in during the manhunt for the shooter. The last office of the Inspector General confirmed Monday that the Internal Affairs Group is investigating a deaf officer's response at the 77th Street station. Captain Dipple Espinosa, a MLAP spokeswoman, said the matter is under administrative investigation and she didn't release more details. Grand jury testimony shows the woman who drove the suspect, Eric R. Holder, away from the March 31st shooting has gone to the station because her car and license plate were on the move. Oh my God, the woman, whose name has not been released, testified that she told her mother, "My car is on here and everything, and I didn't do anything. I didn't know this boy was gonna do this." Her mother called police but was told detectives wouldn't be available until 6 a.m. the next day, grand jury transcripts show. When they arrived at the station the next morning, the front desk officer said don't worry about it and don't listen to the news, the transcript shows. The woman left the station, returning later to speak to detectives after her mother called the police again. Last Detective Cedric Washington testified that the woman has been turned away. "That is true according to the desk officer that I spoke to about it," Washington said. Okay, she apparently missed the briefing in the chief's press conference that day, I guess, Deputy District Attorney John Ginny said. Josh Rubenstein, a MLAP spokesman, said Monday in an email that the internal investigation began a few days ago. "While the initial indications pointed to a miscommunication, we have initiated an administrative investigation to ensure all policies and procedures were followed," Rubenstein wrote. "We will review all statements that have already been given, interview all of the individuals involved, and look for any potential body cam video that may have captured the interchange." Rubenstein told the Los Angeles Times last week there didn't appear to be any misconduct. "She was not making herself clear of what she was doing," Rubenstein said, noting that the officer believed the woman was reporting that someone was just recording video of her car on television. A grand jury on May 9th returned an indictment charging Holder, 29, with murder, attempted murder and other felonies. He has pleaded not guilty. The woman testified that Holder was a friend she had known for about a month and that she believed the two were just stopping at a shopping center for food. She saw Hussle standing outside the South Los Angeles clothing store, the Marathon, expressed her excitement and took a picture with him after overhearing Holder and Hussle's conversation about snitching. The woman and Holder had pulled out of the shopping center and into a nearby gas station when Holder loaded a gun, told her he would be back and walked back to the shopping center, the woman testified. She said she heard two gunshots, and Holder returned moments later telling her to drive. She said she didn't learn Hussle had been shot until later that night. Holder was arrested 2 days later about 20 miles, 32 kilometers, from the crime scene. Hussle, 33, whose real name is Ermias Ashgedom, was a long-respected rapper who had just broken through with a Grammy-nominated album before he was shot and killed. This story has been directed to show that the shooting was March 31st, and the last internal affairs group is investigating. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe.